Thank you for joining us for another Sustainable Living Project video. Today we're going to tan beaver hide. And usually when I tan my hides, like deer hides, I use the wet scrape method, which I have videos for on this channel. But when you want to keep the hair on for a hide, you need to use a dry scraper to dry scrape the hide. And the reason for that is because you're not removing the grain layer from the hair side. And so it's going to be very hard to brain tan the hide. It's going to be very hard for the brains to penetrate the hide. And so what we need to do is we're going to thin out the flesh side of the hide, and that's gonna help for the brains to get in there real well so that it can become soft. And in other videos, like the sheepskin tanning video, we use salt to tan the hide, and that works for very thin hides, but for very thick hides like a buffalo or a beaver, which some people call little buffaloes because their hides are so thick, in this case the hide is so thick that it's going to be extremely hard for the brains to penetrate through the hide if we leave it as is, and using salt will not really work. And so what has happened to this hide is that it was fleshed really well, so all the flesh and fat has been removed, and then it was racked up in a frame like this to dry. And if you don't know how to make a frame like this and how to tie up the hide into it, I'll refer you to my sheepskin tanning videos on this channel. If you start at the part one at the 2:15 time mark, I start explaining how to rack up a hide, and it goes into part two of those videos as well. So, you know, check those out and see how to make those frames. And then, you know, we're picking up at the point where the hide has been dried into the frame and we have good tension all around. The hide is not too floppy. You know, it's not so tight that it's going to tear the edges, so there's a little flex to it. But it needs to be fairly flat. You know, it can't fold onto itself when you push into it. And then in terms of tools, I'm going to use a dry scraper. And a dry scraper is a very sharp tool, because what we're going to do is to shave off the skin on the flesh side. And so it needs to be extremely sharp. And you know, if you're handy with those kinds of things, you can make one yourself. Otherwise, you can buy them online, and braintan.com is a great place to buy those. You know, they're pretty expensive. They're like $80, I believe. But you know, it comes sharp with the right angle and right bevel, and already, you know, all made nicely and stuff. So if you just want to get started, you know, that's a good tool to have. And like I said, it needs to be extremely sharp. And that's it for that. In terms of the hide, you know, like any hide, the beaver hide has different thickness throughout the hide. And so you can tell that by color mainly. You see that the belly, which is right on the outside there, you know, as the hide kind of folds onto itself, you know, beaver hides have a very nice shape. They're very oval. There's no weird things sticking out, you know, like legs, which are more, you know, right here. So it has a more oval, even shape than a deer hide. So it makes it nice to rack up. But you'll see that the belly, you know, is very thin. So it's kind of this white collar that's already been stretched out. And this part will still need to be scraped, though it's very fragile. You know, it needs to be scraped because it has some kind of glue covering on it. You know, the hide has collagen fibers, and this is where the glues of the hides remain. And so, you know, it just kind of has a little dry covering that needs to be scraped off. For the very thin parts on the belly, you might want to use some sandpaper or something just to be safe, because those areas with that kind of dry scraper that's very sharp, you can easily tear into it. So that'd be too bad. But you definitely need to break up that membrane that's there. And then, you know, you see kind of a thinner area on the sides, lighter in color than the center, but darker than the edges. And these two will need to be scraped, but not as much as the back, which is extremely thick. You really see that dark color, just layers upon layers of skin, kind of adds up to being really dark. And you'll see, you know, that the main back is fairly dark, but really the darkest area is the rump and the head. The head is extremely thick, and so if you want to have any hope of the head turning soft, you're really going to have to thin those parts up. And so, you know, that's kind of what you have to keep in mind. Everything needs to be scraped to scrape off that membrane so that the brains can penetrate, but the edges needs to be scraped very lightly. Sandpaper might be safer, you know, than the middle part, scraped a little bit, but it doesn't necessarily need to be thinned much. And then you really want to concentrate on the back, the central part of the hide, so that it becomes as thin as kind of the sides of the hide. And so I'm going to show you how to do that. You don't really want to put your scraper on the hide and put some weight into it, because it's so sharp that you really can cut it. But you kind of want to start with a smooth motion. And I'll just show you. And so, you know, you can see that the skin is being shaved off. And if you want, you can actually save those shavings, because like I said earlier, there's some collagen in there, which is glue. And so you can actually make really good hide glue very easily from those shavings, because it'll be very easy, you know, it's so thin that it'd be very easy to extract the glues out of it. And so, you know, and I may just post an article about that on my blog at some point, how to make glue with the hide shavings. But right now, let's concentrate on thinning out the hide. You know, you want to be somewhat methodical so that you can see your progress. And you'll see that the hide becomes lighter in color. And as you reach different layers of the skin, you know, it may change to darker again, and then you'll get a lighter color as well. But pretty much that's what you want to do. You know, there's nothing complicated about it. You just want to scrape it, like I said, just very lightly on the side, somewhat lightly here, and very heavily through here, especially the head, and really do the whole area like this. And let me just show you a little more like this, and then we'll talk about something else. So, you know, once you scrape for a while, you'll see that you may have little, they're not really cuts, but they're little almost cuts. That goes kind of vertically, horizontally, I mean, across the hide. Anyway, and it's because you may hit another layer of the hide that comes at a different angle. And so you don't want to keep on scraping down the same way when those start to appear, because they'll just get worse and worse, and you'll start digging inside the hide. And you don't want that, because you may just tear through it. And so when you start having those little horizontal, you know, almost cuts to it, you may want to change your angle. Until, you know, that mark disappears, and then you'll see that you'll start having vertical stripes. And so, you know, you can just play with that, see how it works. Sometimes I just go in diagonal like this, and then I'd switch up and go diagonal like this. Kind of does the same thing. But just something to be aware of, that once you see those little lines appear, you don't want to keep on going the same way, because you'll start digging up into the hide. And another thing to talk about is the scraper. You know, like I said, the scraper is extremely sharp, but the hide is extremely strong, and the tool will dull up really, really fast. And you really want to maintain the scraper as sharp as possible, because, you know, you will see that your shavings will become lighter and lighter, and you won't get as much of a bite in the hide, and it will become more of a pain. And so you really want to make an effort to keep your scraper as sharp as possible. And don't let it become dull before you start sharpening it, because then it takes a lot of effort to resharpen it. And, you know, honestly, that's one of the reasons why I just wet scrape my deer hides mostly, is because I don't want to keep on resharpening it. It takes a lot of resharpening. You know, you may just spend 10 minutes only scraping the hides, and then you need to sharpen, and then 10 minutes on the hide and then sharpen. You know, some people like to kind of switch things up like that, but I don't like having to resharpen my tools all the time. But you know, when you do the hair on hides like this, you have to use a dry scraper, and so you have to keep it sharp. And you know, you can just sharpen it whichever way you feel comfortable sharpening it. I've tried different things, and really the thing that works the best for me is that I have this little ceramic rod, and it allows me to sharpen my tool really fast. And then I can just keep it like this, and I just kind of go back and forth along the edge, you know, going the length of the rod until there's a burr that appears on the underneath the scraper. And you really want an even sharpening that follows the curve. You don't want to change the angle, you know, none of that. And I find that doing this with the rod goes really fast and really allows me to be precise. And once you get a little burr that's even, you know, when you just put your finger underneath, you can feel the burr, then you can just start sharpening again. And so that's pretty much what I'm going to keep on doing. You know, I'll take a few hours just scraping, being careful of those lines that form, changing the angles. But pretty much my goal is going to be to just thin out the back, you know, the center part of the hide, just so that it's the same thickness as kind of this area right there. And then we'll just go from there. So.